it was a dream come true lah to actually know that I'll be going to Europe and play. I mean, even though it's only the third division in Spanish football, but I believe in Europe, especially in Spain, you know, they have a certain culture, a certain standard. So I think it'll be a challenge for me, and it'll give me a platform to try to improve myself. Firstly, I think it's not easy to get into Europe in mid-season, especially. You know, the club's already sorted out their club, their players, their team, their dynamics and everything, you know, team ethics. So it's not easy to go in mid-season, especially, I mean, for me coming from Asia or Southeast Asia, we say, it's not easy. So I take it as a challenge that, you know, I have to start from third division. You know, if I play well, if I do well, you never know what will happen. But of course, I think I spoke to a few people that I know, you know, they tell me the Spanish football generally, you know, even the lower divisions is tough. It can be a bit more physical than in the La Liga, because, you know, you have a bit more bigger physical players, as well as players that are out to prove that, you know, they want to play in the second or first division. So I think it will be a good challenge for me to try to step up my game and try to prove myself. So I think it's fine with me. I'm looking forward. Even though I'm 26, turning 27 this year, you know, some people may say it's too late. But for me, if you're good enough, you are old enough, you know. Or age is not really a timeline. If I can do well, if I can play well, and you know, prove something, I think it will be a good way to show for our younger players in Singapore as well. Because I believe that if we have the more players playing, more players we have that playing outside of Singapore, especially in better leagues or better footballing country, it will be better for the national team as well. And of course, it will be a good example or a good target for the younger players, you know, to try to achieve what the older players are achieving. For example, like how Fandi and Sundram were playing in Europe, you know. Then, you know, everybody else was asking, you know, who's going to be the next, you know, who's going to be reaching that level. And so it's the same. If we have like things like this coming up every generation, it's going to be good for the young players. The young players have something to look up to, and naturally it will be better for the national team as well.